Mm-hmm. Wait, Shinomi, do we need some work? Mm-mm.
We are in the taxpayer's
side. And they are not paying you to make out with me.
We could reimburse them.
Okay.
Yeah?
Hi, Captain Bishop. Sorry to interrupt. Your mom is here?
Mom?
This is such good questions, guys. The handhold tonight, planned or no planned. They were not in the script. They were not written. Instinctually, it just happens. Me and Stefania do have an insane amount of I guess you could call that chemistry. There's certain scene partners you have that it just works, and other scene partners where it just feels like it's difficult, or you're like magnets, like two magnets. It either feels like you're attracting, or two magnets that are just like, no matter what you do, you can't get them to touch. And that's the best visual I can kind of give. And with me and Stefania, it feels like we're two magnets, and we kind of instinctually do things in scenes that just happen. And then luckily you have a director like Pete who captures it. And so both handholds, I don't know if you guys noticed in the first scene of the episode, when my mom first comes in, I'm trying to grab at her hand. And like, I'm doing this kind of thing. I'm like, don't leave, please don't leave, please don't leave. And she leaves the room.
Hi.
Hi.
Are you one of Maya's fire women?
No, I'm not a firefighter. I'm Dr. Karina De Luca.
Oh, you're my daughter's doctor.
I am a doctor, but I'm not Maya's. I am actually...
Did I walk in at a bad time?
Oh no. No. I was just about to leave. I've already wasted enough taxpayers' time, but it was wonderful to meet you.
And then in the end, it kind of comes full circle. It gave me goosebumps just talking about it. And at the end, it kind of came full circle that when, you know, I'm mad at my mom being there and kind of feeling betrayed that Stefania's there being all buddy-buddy with my mom, who I'm angry at and have all these emotions for, and she goes to grab my hand, and I actually don't grip her hand. I just kind of have a limp hand, and then I pull it away. That was all unplanned.
Abuse is making you walk home 20 miles from your track meet for coming in second.
I came in first, actually. But I didn't beat my own time.
Come with me to my next therapy session.
I beat it the next time. You know, I agree. You need therapy. And I'm good.
So, you know, until we got in the scene, and then it just felt so right. It felt good for her. I think Stefania is the one that came up with that in the second part of like, the reason she came at me was to kind of comfort me and to give me and to hold my hand. And I just wouldn't. And then my reaction was just, I wouldn't accept it. And so that was very much impromptu with me and Stefania. And it's such a joy acting with so many amazing actors.
Do you ever improvise during scenes?
I love improvising. I always do that. Some writers love it. Some writers, none of them really discourage you from do it, but I really love improvising, especially because there is the Italian and the English, and sometimes they put it there, but I change it up or add more. And sometimes it doesn't go with the scene, so we take it out, but they always encourage us to play and do improvise if we feel comfortable doing that.
For example, the bacio scene. Dame un bacio.
Yeah.
Can you tell us about that? Because
it was improvised, right?
A lot of people say that was improvised, and we're freaking out about it.
Sei bellissima. Sei forte. Sei tenace.
I don't understand a word of this, but somehow it's working.
Go shine your light, bella. Tell your truth.
Dammi un bacio.
Was that kiss me?
Yeah.
Was it or it wasn't?
Tell us, please. Can you tell
us? It was improvised. It was. It wasn't in the script. And I don't remember why I said it. I think there was a little time when we were kind of far away in the take. And I was like, okay, dammi un bacio. And then we kissed. So it happened once, and then the director asked me to do it every take. But yeah, it was improvised.
We got to say we are big fans of that scene. Just got to tell you that much. Yes, that's a very good you improvise really nicely, and we all like it, and we thank you for it.
Thank you.
I would love a scene where Karina is speaking Italian, or I'm learning to speak Italian in the show. Stefania absolutely says a lot of Italian words to me on camera that aren't scripted, that I absolutely love when she says, and I'm always like, what are you saying to me? And it's usually kiss me. So I would love it if that was the scene. Like if there was a funny little scene of her trying to get me to learn some Italian, that would be awesome. Or maybe, you know, I don't know. So many ideas in my head now.
Shower first.
Seriously?
Bambina.
It's Andy. It's a family thing.
Bambina, we're fine here. You can go.
Okay. Sissy. Okay. And you are a doctor. We need you here.
Yeah, but they need me there more. Italy is dying, Bambina.
What you and I have is,
And the only things that I know that are kind of added, like I said, are when Stefania at the end of a scene, they usually roll a lot of the scenes with Stefania and I. They don't say cut right away. So me and Stefania will be doing a scene and, you know, it ends with us, you know, super close or kissing or, and they just keep rolling. They don't say cut. And then that's when Stefania usually adds in some Italian, or she's very good at ad-libbing little things there at the end, and then I'll usually respond. And so those are the only times that things are kind of added, but for the most part, for me specifically, everything is scripted. And the writers are amazing.
What's your favorite kiss between Karina and Maya?
Okay. You know what? One of my favorite kisses is the one after she's crying. She's saying, I'm the fire truck. Their crushes. I feel like that scene isn't necessarily sexy, but I love the intimacy of the scene, and I love giving her the kiss. It was like a kiss on the cheek, but it felt very sweet and it felt very loving and very genuine. So I really like that scene. Because none of those things are scripted. They don't say, now Karina kisses Maya and now she hugs her. So we have to figure it out as we're doing it. And it's a very like emotional scene for Danielle, so she has to be crying and the preparation for that. So it's like, oh, I literally felt like, oh my God, Poverina, I want to hug you, I want to kiss you, please don't cry.
Well, I'm very glad you called, but I should go back to work now.
I'm the truck.
Sorry, I'm not very good at American idioms.
I'm the truck. I'm the truck that drunkenly plowed into Station 19 and destroyed an entire family.
Hey,
I'm the truck.
I love when you do that in your scenes too. Like so much of you comes out when you play Karina. Like I notice little things, like when you were asking about in tonight's episode, make sure I don't spill the beans. There's a scene where you ask a little bit of a hot button question and you do this thing that's very much you, where you're like, ooh.
I don't.
And I'm like, that is 100% Stefania right there.
Okay, you sure you don't want to invite your parents?
Well, I don't even know where Mason is.
So I love that we both feel so comfortable with each other that we can bring elements of ourselves into the characters. So
I said that you're very much on by the book, because I kind of take liberty to go sometimes and add things, and the writers are always so nice and welcoming, and when they think it's too much, they're like, ah, Stefania, this means something completely different. I'm like, okay, then I'll change it back.
That's the American idioms? Oh, yeah, sorry. No, I didn't get that. But all saying that too is I think we balance each other out in that sense, because I'm so structured and by the book and like type A, and you're very like let's just go with the flow, and I think it helps me. I don't know about if it makes you any more like type A, which you're not anywhere near, but like if it makes you more, if that, but it for sure makes me more relaxed and like go with it, because you're kind of like, you give me that permission.
I love it. And I love, because you give me structure. I feel like sometimes you're like, okay, let's run the scene. And I'm like, okay.
Yeah, I
get to set very prepared rather than just going with the flow full blown. So I think we're good. We're good for a show.
So I think we've come to the conclusion that we are a very good balance.
Yeah.
I love it.
Spring is here. Sky is blue.
Okay. I'm getting a little concerned about how giddy you are. I'm giddy too, though.
Yeah.
You feel guilty that Warren is not seeing his wife and kids, and we're here in the shack.
In the shack?
On the shack? What is it?
Oh, you mean shacking up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No. Don't do that.
No. We front-loaded all of our drama pre-wedding.
Yeah.
Hey, newlyweds.
Come over and hear screaming from down the hall, you know. She runs into her bedroom, slams the door. They said
I'm meant to be. I'm coming with you.
Where are you checking out?
She is mine.
Maya, it's ours. It's just ours.
If you wanted to keep making your point.